This is a grant that Betsy and I received through the New York Farm Viability Institute. And it's a really neat source of funding. It's a new type of funding that they're offering. And one of the benefits is that it gets us working with the individual farmer, lets us collect data on the individual farms as well as on a group of farms so that we're able to provide feedback to the individual farmers. And in this case, it's smaller farmers, Tiestall farmers. So we don't always do a lot of research on that demographic, especially in New York. So it's nice that we're able to target those farms and give them information specific to them.
We meet with farms four different times throughout the study. The first time is to gather information about the farm, their management practices, how often they bed, how often they feed, how many times a day they milk. Just some simple questions.
Tim and Debbie Lawton in Newark Valley and Lawton's Jersey Farm. About 80 milking cows and close to 100 mature cows. We're small, but we try to do the best we can with every animal.
So we typically are working with farms that are eager to make changes, that they want to make a positive impact on the well-being of their animals.
If there's something that we can do in here with the stalls or the facilities that can make it better for the cows, that interests us, you know.
So we're looking at stall dimensions, so where the cows are laying down, does she have enough space, how much bedding does she have, so are you making it a comfortable place for her to lay down. And then we're looking at the individual animal, so how much time is she spending laying down, how often does she get up and down, those are indications of how comfortable she is and how well she fits into her lying surface. And then if she has any injuries on her body, again, would be indications of whether or not she's fitting into that stall and if she's comfortable.
I'm Jessica Curry. We're located in Tully, New York at Curry Holsteins. At this facility, we milk about 42 cows, and we have another 900 cows down the road at a freestall barn. We focus in genetics and really want to make sure that we have comfortable cows that are high producers and that are going to last a long time in our herd.
They want to know what factors will make their cows more comfortable. And they want to understand their barns better and how do we size their stalls more correctly to the animals that they have. We're putting the data loggers on where we measure lying time. We'll be measuring cows and collecting that data. The data loggers are on for a week.
It tells us every minute of the day whether she's laying down or whether she's standing up.
So we're able to give them data specific to their facility that, okay, their cows are such size, your stalls need to be this size. So it's really specific to their situation.
A little over a year ago, we did an assessment here with Cornell Cooperative Extension, and it made us really look at some of the things we can still improve to make our cows even more comfortable. We have changed some things. We have added some sprinklers and some fans, and are looking to adjust our tie rails so that the cows can eat and drink more freely. Oh, we've seen a lot of benefits with the cows lying down longer, especially at the end of the barn.
Being able to give farmers information that they actually find valuable to them, or at least in some cases even, you know, they had a hunch that something needed to change, but being able to give them concrete evidence of what that thing is so that they can then make the best decision.
To be able to see actual data, to be able to make decisions, because these decisions help our cows, helps our management, and ultimately helps us financially.
So it's just really fulfilling to be able to solve a problem and give farm-specific data back to them. It's not just a cookie-cutter approach.
Every farm, the combination will be a little bit different. There is no one thing that'll get you all the way to success. It's a combination. Put everything together. I think it's all about continual improvement.
You really want to make sure that everything is clean and comfortable, and that they aren't stressed because of heat, so that they will make a lot of milk and last a long time and be happy. Because it is really, you know, happy cows are healthy cows, and they make milk and they want to produce for you.